Hey, I'm Jesse. This is our final devotion in the Behold the Harvest series. Now, fret not, I'm going to continue sharing the gospel every time that I preach. So the come and see evangelism, as we studied in our curriculum 2 weeks ago in John chapter 4, the woman at the well, that option is always going to be there. This doesn't mean that we're not allowed to talk about evangelism ever again, but I do want to wrap us up by coming again from the book of Revelation to have the big picture in mind, the ending in mind. This is why we evangelize. This is why we go on global mission. This news is just too good to keep to ourselves. Listen to these opening words from the final chapter of the Bible, Revelation 22. Then he showed me the river, the water of life, clear as crystal, flowing from the throne of God and from the Lamb, down the middle of the city's main street. The tree of life was on each side of the river, bearing 12 kinds of fruit, producing its fruit every month. The leaves of the tree are for the healing of the nations, and there will no longer be any curse. The throne of God and of the Lamb will be in the city, and his servants will worship him. They will see his face, and his name will be on their foreheads. All right, this is like the phylacteries that were prescribed in the Old Testament. Night will be no more. People will not need the light of a lamp or the light of the sun, because the Lord God will give them light, and they will reign forever and ever. This is how the closing chapter of the Bible opens. Look as well to the healing of the nations. We saw in Eden, there was this tree, the knowledge of good and evil. There's this tree again in Revelation 22. Everything kind of happens between these two trees. It begins with the tree, it ends with this tree of life. And in verse 2 of Revelation 22, the tree of life was on each side of the river. So you can picture this tree that spans across the river, or whose roots divide across the river. I don't totally understand exactly how that works, but I know that there is this river of the water of life flowing right down the main street of the city. What did Jesus say about himself to the woman at the well in John chapter 4? I am the living water. Whoever drinks from me will never thirst again. This is what he was foreshadowing. This is what he was describing. This is what he knows. There's this river of life, clear as crystal, that flows down the middle of the street from the throne of God and down the middle of the city street. And the tree of life is on each side of the river, bearing 12 kinds of fruit, producing its fruit every month. The leaves of the tree are for the healing of the nations. So it bears 12 kinds of fruit. The number 12 pops up all over the place. There's a wall around the heavenly city, and the foundation of that wall has 12 layers to it. And these represent the 12 tribes of Israel. And these gates that are all made out of a solid pearl, like, their number is deliberate as well. The 12 kinds of fruit from the tree of life, that's also deliberate as well. You can see this covenant that God made with Abraham, this Old Testament election covenant, the corporate election of the nation of Israel was according to the 12 tribes of Israel. That's Old Testament salvation right there. And then it comes back again in Revelation, where there's 12,000 from each of the tribes of Israel that is called into heaven, this mass revival. Those 12 kinds of fruit are also reminiscent of the 12 tribes of Israel, but then the leaves from this tree are for the healing of the nations. Man, you don't have to watch international headlines for very long to understand what that healing is necessary for. Like, God sees it all, and he has it all. He has a method by which to heal the nations. In the previous verses, we see the nations bringing their glory into the city of heaven, and now we see God providing healing for the nations. There's no other text like this in the world. There's no other faith system that has such an incredible promise. Okay, I'm sorry if you've been in a beauty contest before and you come out talking about world peace and waving your hand like this. Like, you got nothing on this. I'm sorry, there's nothing in the universe like this. This beautiful creator God who does away with the curse, of which all of the fallen behaviors we observe, and cancer and car wrecks and early deaths and terrorism, and all, they're all symptomatic of that curse. They're all sin that's symptomatic of that very curse that is ended here, that it ends with healing, the healing of the nations. Yes, that includes Sudan. Yes, that includes North Korea. Yes, that includes Afghanistan. Like, that God has a means by which he would heal the nations. No, that doesn't mean that they're all going to be corporately saved. I'm not a universalist. Very few people find their way to salvation. They can't come unless the Father draws them. But in the end, there is healing, healing, healing for the nations. The nations need to hear this, man. They live their whole lives without hearing the gospel. How can they call upon the God they've not believed in? How can they believe unless they hear? How can they hear unless someone preaches to them? How can they preach unless they are sent? How beautiful are the feet of those who bring the gospel of peace. Jesse, do the people who live and die out of the reach of the gospel in the name of Jesus go to hell when they die? Yes. Why? Because according to 2 Corinthians 5, we're all judged. We all must give an account for what we've done, whether good or evil. We see that as well in chapter 22 of Revelation. Look, I am coming soon. My reward is with me to repay each person according to his work. That's Revelation 22, 12. We're all going to stand in judgment before God and give an account for what we've done. And as we've seen in our evangelism training series, Romans 3, 23, we have all sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. As we've all seen in Romans 6, 23, the wages of that sin is death. That means that by default, we're headed towards hell. See John 3, 36. But if we have the Son, we have eternal life. This is the will of God. This is the healing for the nations. This is the only way to be saved, because by default, we are under God's wrath, but then came Jesus. So what's it gonna be? You can, as a fellow Christian, know this beautiful promise, see this promise of the tree of life whose leaves give healing for the nations, and look to national headlines. And you can rant and rave, and you can sip your coffee and then kick back in your recliner, or you can obey God's calling if he calls you to go to the nations. I can tell you firsthand, it's been nothing but an enriching experience for me as God's called me to go to several countries around the world to proclaim the gospel and to encourage believers, to equip pastors and encourage missionaries. I come back home refreshed and ready to smack a demon. I come back home ready and praying. It's partly why I keep using this word revival, because I've seen God do it in the nations, and I know that he can do it here. Would you join me in one last prayer as we close out the Behold the Harvest series, having beheld how the story ends? I just spoiled the ending for you. You and I get to play a part in this epic of redemption, where the curse is broken, the nations are healed, where we all stand before God. So what are you gonna do with this information? Let's pray together. God, I lift up my brothers and sisters. I thank you for those who have been with us for every sermon and curriculum session and every devotion through this series. I pray, God, you have already saved people through this series. That blesses my soul immensely. I pray that you would now anoint every person who's gone through this series after we've gone through it to bear even more fruit, that bears even more fruit, that bears even more fruit. I pray that we would get to see this ourselves and invite others into it. That we would evangelize others who evangelize others. That the friends of our friends would get to see this tree of life whose leaves provide healing for the nations, God. What could be more important in our lives than answering this call and inviting others to this healing and this heavenly city, Jesus? I pray that you would call forth missionaries, that people would leave everything behind and answer your call to go on mission. I pray that we would speak up about our faith and lead others to Christ. And then I pray that we would then teach them to lead others to Christ. In a time capsule of sorts, by faith, God, I just speak now to those who are watching this video a year after it's been made, because they've been led to Christ by someone who was led to Christ at the Redemption Church. God, I hope that I have similar amount of hair by that time. But if I don't, God, I just lift up in faith the exponential growth factor. Because in this time capsule, I'm praying for people who have been led to Christ by members of the Redemption Church and are now leading others to Christ at the Redemption Church and leading others to Christ. God, I pray that this anointing would carry forward, that we would all get to experience this together. Thank you for your promise. Thank you for your word. We obey your great commission. And we place our hope in this beautiful heaven above. May we bring as many people as we can from every nation to this healing. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.